of the body where it's easier to hit and you got a greater chance to land it than you do to the head. So he's good move right now for Deontay Wilder.
Nice right hand to the body off the jab. A very different Deontay Wilder. We're talking 25 seconds run ups into the first fight, into this first round.
He wants to punch down to his body, then bring it up to the head. Get him looking down the board about the bottom of his body, and then come over the right top right with his right hand.
Wilder throwing that stick out. We have not seen a strong jab in a long time. We have not seen an outstanding work rate from Wilder in a long time. He looks outstanding in the first minute of this fight.
He's got Fury on his back foot a little bit, guessing, because he's not just trying to come forward. I'm talking about Wilder. He's being very successful with his approach coming forward.
If I was Tyson Fury right now, I'd be jabbing him back to the belly too.
Fury is trying to assess what's happening right now. He's looking at Wilder. Wilder is turned a little more, you know, with his left side forward. So he's just showing that left shoulder and then snapping out a strong, long jab.
Wilder's going to be coming up top. Curves here shortly with that right hand.
In the small bits of success that Wilder has had in these first two fights, it has come when he's been active. Now comes Tyson Fury, and he throws a right hand and then grabs immediately. Surprising. In the second fight, he would fall and put his body weight on Wilder. But the demeanor, the fighting spirit, already looks different for Wilder.
Well, Wilder has a game plan this time. He's not just relying on that right hand, and that's what we wanted to see unfold, to see what changes were made and what his game plan was going to be. And it looks like he's trying to set the right hand.
Fury is very good at dodging that right hand, but Wilder throwing it is an outstanding sign for him.
Wilder should throw that jab to the belly, then to the head, and mix it up, not just to the belly.
He's coming up top. He's just taking his time right now.
Already Deontay Wilder throwing 12 jabs in this round. That is an outstanding sign. Again, Fury has not been damaged, but he's taken some body shots, and already these are scoring shots from Deontay Wilder.
Well, not just scoring, but they're doing damage that show up.
Fury knows he's in a very different battle. You can see in the look in his eyes as he lands a hook, stepping forward.
Stop! Let go!
Again, you can only control certain things, but you can control the work rate, and Wilder looks different in the third fight. One, two for Fury. He starts to get into a rhythm. We've been saying all night, you will learn a lot about Fury.
And here's a good right hand by Tyson Fury, right on the chin of Deontay. Deontay handled that right hand really good. That's a wake-up shot.
He's getting tired now. You see it? Excellent. He's setting the trap. You already caught him with a little easy one, too. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, shit.
In a minute, you're going to be able to just see him come with that shit just...
One round in, and already all the makings of an outstanding fight.
Yes,
that was a big turn of events from Deontay Wilder, and then Fury at the end of the round showed, oh no, I'm the king, and landed a beautiful right hand. Round two, scheduled for the championship 12. Wilder jabbing immediately. Fury not showing the same head movement that he did in the first fight, where he was constantly moving his head and fainting and double fainting.
Yeah, he's not moving his upper body or his legs like he was.
Wilder comes with the right hand and looked off balance. I don't know if he was hurt or just lost his way.
But I think Fury, like you said, Ryan, was just processing because Deontay came out so strong. He applied a game plan that he hadn't applied before.
Hard shot right on the belt. Wilder's
telegraphing his right hand when he should. He's got to set it up with a jab or something else, or a jab for the belly.
Lennox, you have to like the work rate, though, right?
Oh, yeah,
something here.
Well, I like the work rate. He realized the last fight he didn't go to the stomach and the belly, but this fight he's definitely going to the knee. And I know that's Malik Scott telling him to do that.
But Wilder was brought along very slowly after winning the Olympic bronze medal. He started boxing at the age of 19. But again, by the time he fought for the title and remains to earn, he showed a good, hard jab. And that made all the difference in the world. He's gotten away from that, fell in love with his power, is able to bail himself out with his tremendous power. Fury, bailing Max, is not going to get anywhere near that right hand. Fury's not just showing respect. See that? He's like, no, no, no. Get out of here.
See, that's what Deontay has to worry about, because Tyson Fury knows what he's trying to do right now. Block that, and it's really block that jab to the belly and come back with the left right.
Good body shot. Russell Moore, good job. Moore getting in there and said, look, you can let those guys punch out of that. Let the box. Good job by Russell Moore.
Both fighters in that exchange are giving just as much as they gave.
Nice right hand, Wilder. Able to touch him. Box comes Fury. And that's the second time, Andre, we've seen that. Fury lands right hand and clutches.
I don't think he's comfortable right now to let both hands go. He wants to kind of land a 1-2 and make sure he's secure and safe. And then be set.
Jab to the body from Wilder.
Yeah, he can't go away from that. That was...